Mamata Banerjee is felicitated with yellow roses. As I told you earlier, yellow roses symbolizes true friendship. May I now invite our guest of honor, Most Reverend Theodore Mascarenhas, Secretary General of CBCI, to say a few words.
Our honorable chief guest, Srimati Mamata Banerjee, Archbishop Thomas, my good friend Swami Sushil Maharaj is here, Bishop is here, fathers, sisters, brothers and sisters. Mother Teresa once said, every time you smile at someone, it is an action of love, a gift to that person, a beautiful thing. And therefore, let me start with a smile. We are gathered together here with a very special theme. Love your neighbor as yourself, as Jesus taught us. A theme that for over 2,000 years throughout the world and in this country has been running into the blood of Christians, running into the blood of our fellow countrymen, and we have been serving our country together. What does it mean, love your neighbor? Jesus was asked the same question. And he gave a beautiful answer, telling a little story. There was a man who was coming from Jericho to Jerusalem. On the way, he was waylaid by robbers, left there, injured, wounded. A priest passed by, walked away without doing anything. A lawyer passed by, walked away without doing anything. Then came a man, a Samaritan, a man who was considered outcast in society, lifted him up, took him to the inn, healed his wounds, and left his own money with the innkeeper to take care of the man. That is the meaning of love your neighbor. And that is the message that we want to go throughout the country. Love your neighbor as yourself. Who is our neighbor? Everyone. Everyone. Everyone is my brother and sister in this country, over the world. My dear brothers and sisters, I'd like to begin by saluting those valiant missionaries who over the years have struggled in the jungles, worked for the poor, for the deprived populations of society. I know sisters and fathers who have died at the age of 38, 39 of malaria. They had no need of going to the forest. They went because this command, love your neighbor, went with them, carried the message, and they wanted to bring that love, bring that healing touch to people. We salute them. I met a top leader in Jharkhand recently, and he told me, he's not a Christian, not a Catholic, and he told me, Father, I can never forget, when I was a child, I went to a mission school. If there was no mission school, I would have never had education. And I can never forget that French sister, old sister. I had a wound on my leg. She used to lift me up and take me for my meals and bring me back. And I saw this, I wouldn't say hardened political leader, but a leader who was there, who could realize, and there were tears in his eyes. And he told me, "You fathers, sisters, you live in the jungles for months, for years. I would not have been able to live for a single day, maybe 2 days at the most. I would come back." That is why I salute those who love their neighbors, not simply Christian missionaries. People of all walks of life, of goodwill, filled with this blood of love your neighbor, who go around spreading good, spreading this message of love, not simply through words, but through action. But before I go on, let me come to our Didi. The first time I met her, it was in Dubai. I was graciously invited by our foreign minister, Mrs. Sushma Swaraj, to be part of the delegation that went for the canonization of Mother Teresa. And we were there at Dubai to change planes. And Didi came with her group from Bengal. And I can never forget that scene. These two lovely women, Sushma Swaraj on one side and Mamta Didi on the other side. And they embraced each other. And I was wondering whether they really belong to two different political parties. But there was that love your neighbor. And I began following both of them after that, both on Twitter, the things they were doing. And I noticed both engaged in works of compassion. Sushma Swaraj, anytime she gets a tweet, somebody is stranded somewhere, somebody is stuck somewhere, she moves all her offices to get that person out. You see that compassion, you see that love for neighbor. And Mamta Didi going out to the villages, reaching out to people, that compassion, that love. That is what this country needs. That is what all of us need. It doesn't matter to which party you belong. We don't care for which party you belong. We care for what party your heart belongs to. And that party should be the party of love. That party of love your neighbor. During the panel discussion, somebody was speaking about conversions. Yes, I'm here to convert you, each one of you, to convert you to love, to convert you to compassion, to convert you for the love for the poor, for the tribals, for the Dalits. That is our mission. And we will carry on that mission no matter who tries to stop us. Our mission for the underprivileged, our mission for the poor, that mission will go on. And it will go on at all costs. My dear brothers and sisters, Mahatma Gandhi said, "Jesus lived and died in vain if he did not teach us to regulate the whole of life by the eternal law of love." He said this in 1939, writing in the Harijan. Jesus lived and died in vain if we do not know to regulate our lives of love. And you know, when the organizers came to me and said, "Mamta Didi is going to be our chief guest," and asked why, and one of them told me, "Mother Teresa comes from Kolkata, and Mamta Didi knew her very well. And there, from Kolkata, Mother Teresa's sisters have been showering love throughout the country. They may be in a little bit of difficulty today, but not for their fault, I can guarantee you that. But that fountain of love which Mother Teresa started, going throughout India, throughout the world. And I thought Mamta Didi being here this evening for this love your neighbor, when probably she has learned something from Mother Teresa, how to love your neighbor in love and action. I want to express the gratitude of the Catholic Church and all of us Christians to every government, past and present. Without the help, governance, and guidance of every government, we would not have been able to do for the country what we are doing today. And I want to exclude no one. I go to Rajnath Singh ji, he is there to help us. I went the other day to our health minister, Nadda ji, he is there to help us. When we go, their doors are open to us. I must say that. And therefore, we want to thank every government. Mamata Didi has been a little special to us in Kolkata and in West Bengal, helping the Christians going out of the way. And we would like to collaborate with every part of government, with every government, because as someone said in the panel discussion, our work, our mission is to serve everyone, irrespective of caste, creed, religion, region, language, where you come from, where you go, we are not interested. But we are interested in one thing. We are interested in the poorest of the poor more than anybody else. I was telling a group of doctors in Ranchi when I was talking to them, the rich, the powerful, they have their money, they have their power to influence and get their things done. The poor have no one but us, men and women of goodwill. And therefore, our heart beats for them, our heart goes for them. We have, a few years ago, or 2 years ago, we celebrated the canonization of Mother Teresa here. And you know, Rajnath Singh ji was our chief guest at that function. And he has some beautiful things to say about Mother Teresa. He said, Mother Teresa has always been referred as mother because of the love given by her as a mother. What beautiful words. And then he said, two people came from two Macedonias. Alexander came from Macedonia to conquer. And Mother Teresa came from the other Macedonia, and she conquered with her love. That is the beauty of love. I want to say a word. I never like to be long, but I want to say a word to our younger generation, number of youngsters, that they're so beautiful to see you here. You are the future of our country. And you will set the way we go forward. We want each one of you to be the torchbearers of love. This country has been famous over the centuries for its traditions of love, peace, and harmony. That love, peace, and harmony, my dear young men and women, is in your hands. Never let hatred beat in your hearts. Love your neighbor. We do not care who that neighbor is. We do not know who that neighbor is. But we love him, we serve him, and we want to be at the service. We pray for our country. We pray that this great country might continue to give the light of love to the rest of the world. We love this country. When somebody said, some fool sometimes makes statements, somebody said, Christians are anti-national. And a reporter asked me, you Christians are anti-national, so and so said that. I told him, that's his personal opinion. The vast majority of Indians does not think so, because we have been a peace-loving community, we will continue to be a peace-loving community, and we will continue to love our neighbors, whatever it may cost us and how long it may cost us. Thank you. God bless you.